وما أرسلنا قبلك إلا رجالا نوحي إليهم فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Today, inshallah, we're going to carry on. We're going to talk about the letters which are heavy, which one are light. Are light in Arabic is called tafkhim and tarqiq. So the heavy is tafkhim and the light is tarqiq. The heavy, we can say it is heaviness that is added to the letter. So the mouth is filled with heavy sound. The method of making the letter heavy is just by elevating the deepest part of the tongue towards the roof of the mouth. So when the sound is coming out from your lungs, if you elevate the back of the tongue, the sound will be diverted to the roof of the mouth. So when it hits the roof of the mouth, it comes down and then the mouth is filled with the heavy sound. The light is thinness that is added to the letter, so the mouth is not filled with heavy sound. And the method of doing this is just by keeping the deepest part of the tongue lowered. So when the sound is coming out from your lungs, it will go straight out from your mouth. So the sound stays light. It doesn't hit the roof of the mouth. It comes down and it have the heavy sound. The levels of tafkhim, levels of heaviness, are five. One, which is the highest level, is when heavy letters has fatha and followed by alif, like qala, qala. So qaf is one of the heavy letters and it is followed by alif. So this is the highest level. The second level is when heavy letter has a fatha, like talaqtumuhunna, talaqa, talaqakunna, and so on. The next level is when heavy letter has a dhamma, like ظُلُمَاتٍ ظُلُمَاتٍ. The next level is when heavy letter has a sukun, like الْمَغْضُوبِ الْمَغْضُوبِ. The last level is when heavy letter has a kasra, like صِرَاطَ صِرَاطَ. So this is the five levels of heaviness and thinness, تَفْخِيمُ وَتَرْقِيقُ. Now, the groups of the Arabic letters, heavy and light. The Arabic letters are divided into three groups. One, letters that are always heavy. The letters of elevation. Kha, Saad, Daad, Ghain, Ta, Qaf, Dha. These letters are combined in one sentence. Khussa, Baghtin, Qidh. That's how what the scholars they do. They combine everything like this so people can memorize it easy. خُصَ بَغْطٍ قِذْ. That's the letters which are always heavy. Two letters that are heavy sometimes and are light sometimes. The Alif, Mad, the Lam of the grand name, the letter Ra. The alif of the grand name, like as-sa-khuh. So now the alif is heavy. Light, as-sama, now is light. The lamb of the grand name, which is the word of Allah, heavy, Allah, light, lillah. The letter ra, heavy, as-sirata, light, min sharri. The third group, which is the rest of the Arabic letters after the letters of heaviness, and after the letters which are light sometimes and heavy sometimes, the rest of the Arabic after this is all light and always light. We're going to talk more details about the second group. We start with the alif. The alif, as I told you, is not categorized as heavy or light, but it follows the letter before it. If the letter before it is heavy, then it will also be heavy, like waqala, as-sakha, at-tariq, and so on. If the letter before it is light, then it will also be light, like wal-fariqati, wal-nashitati, and so on. The lamb of the grand name Allah, is preceded by fatha or dhamma, it is then pronounced heavy, like ulaika hizbullah. So hizbu, we have ba at the end of hizbu, and then we have the grand name hizbullah. So we can't say hizbullah, is wrong. Fatha ala inna hizballahi, so we can't say hizballahi, is wrong. Now if it's preceded by kasra, it will be pronounced light, like qulillahu alhamdulillahi alhamdulillahi. So the lamb of the grand name is preceded by the kasra. So the grand name, if it's preceded by dhamma or fatha, the lamb of it will be heavy, mufakhama. If it's preceded by kasra, the lamb of the grand name will be light. Qulillahu alhamdulillahi, and so on. If the grand name is preceded by sukun, then the letter before it has fatha or dhamma, the lamb of the grand name should be pronounced heavy. So if the grand name is preceded by fatha, like asa, preceded by sukun, like asa, asa, the last letter of it has a sukun, alif, maqsura. So now we have to look the letter before it. If the letter before it has a fatha, then the lamb of the grand name will be heavy. Same wattaqu Allah. So we have the waw before it, which has a sukun, and the qaf before the waw has a dhamma. So the grand name will be elevated. If the grand name is preceded by sukun and the letter before that letter has a kasra, the lamb of the grand name, it will be light, like ya'ti Allahu, and so on. So the grand name, if it's preceded by dhamma or fatha, the lamb of the grand name will be heavy. If preceded by kasra, the lamb of the grand name will be light. And then if there is a sukun before it, the same rule apply. Before sukun, if there is dhamma or fatha, it will be heavy. If there is kasra, it will be light. Now the letter ra. The letter ra can be heavy and light as well. The letter ra has five cases in where it is pronounced heavy, four cases where it is pronounced light, two cases that follows either heavy or light. The five cases of the heavy ra: one, if with fatha or dhamma, like Ramadan, araita, rumman, al-kafirun. If unvowled and preceded by fatha or dhamma, like Maryam, Mar, so Maryam, so we look at the letter before it. Al-Arham, Al-Furqan, Al-Qur'an, and so on. If unvowled preceded by unvowed letter, except the unvowled ya, and that letter is preceded by fatha or dhamma, like wal-fajr. So we have ra has sukun, we have jim before it has sukun, and then we have fa have fatha. Wal-fajr, wal-asr, kufr, khusr, and so on. Number four, if unvowled and preceded by a conditional kasra, hamzatul wasl. Inshallah, we're going to do it in the future. While the reader is starting on the conditional kasra, so you are starting the reading with the conditional kasra, like irja', irkab, and so on. The hamzatul wasl, the conditional kasra, if we carry on from before, it will be dropped. We're going to talk about it, inshallah, in details. Like, liman irtada, if we start irtada, but if we carry on from the word before, liman irtada, we cancel the hamzat al-wasl. Number five, if unvowled and preceded by kasra and followed by elevated letter that does not have a kasra. This one, there is only five words in the Qur'an, which is qirtas, mirsad, labil mirsad, firqah, irsada. This is the only five words which this rule apply. Now we talk about the four cases of the light ra. There is two conditions for the light ra to be pronounced light. One, if followed by a lowered letter. Two, if the letter before it has an original kasra. These conditions make the light in four different cases. One, if with the kasra, like rijal, mujarimin. Two, if unvowled and preceded by kasra, and the following letter is not an elevated letter, like miryah, fir'aun, and so on. Three, if unvowled and preceded by sukun, and the letter before it has a kasra, like hijr, hijr, sihr, hijr, sihr, and so on. Four, if unvowled and preceded by unvowled ya, like khayr, bayr, and so on. The two cases of the heavy and the light ra where it is allowed. If unvowled and preceded by kasra and followed by one of the elevated letters with a kasra. There is only one example of this in the Qur'an, that is in the word firqa, 2663. The two different way of reading the ra applies only one continuing reading and not one stopping. If stopping on the word firq, the ra is pronounced heavy according to one of the five cases where the ra is heavy. Two, if unvowed and preceded by unvowed elevated letter, and that letter preceded by kasra, there are two words in the Quran that have these circumstances, one stopping on them. They are the word qitr, 3412, the word misr, 12, 21, 99, and 43, 51. These two words, when stopping on them, the ra can be read heavy or light. There is only one ra in one word in the whole of the Quran, which none of these rules applies to it, and it has the rule of imala. You can call it deflection. In the word majaraha, Surah 1141. So this one is read by imala. So you don't say majara, because we said if ra, it has a fatha, it's elevated. So this word specially, we don't read it from the narration from the way of Shatibiyah. We don't read it majaraha, but we read it majareha. So this one is called imala in Arabic. This is the end of this lesson, inshallah. Until next time, subhanakallah wa bihamdik, shahadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.